Oneself for coming to Harvard.
In the course of living, we are often given privileges, be it being rich, being healthy, or being famous. And more often than so, those things blind us. They can do more bad than good. Have you ever had that moment where you feel high and mighty, but it drowns you so much? Now here is a story of growth, self-sacrifice, and challenges. Let's hop onto memory lane, back to when I was 10 years old, more than a decade ago. When I was a child, I was smart in academics, gifted, as you might say. A dream many parents yearn for their children. I was showered with compliments, awards, number ones. So I lived this way. But there was a consequence of this. I was empty. I felt empty. I was egoistic. I looked down on everyone. I looked down on everybody who was not number one. The more compliments I get, the less they matter. And as I grew, these things happened. Primary 6, 5 days from my PSR. No big deal. It was easy. I mean, how can anybody not do it, right? So I went to high school, a whole different environment. The first half of the year, the test, I ranked top 10. Okay, it was not bad. I mean, this was the smartest school in Brunei. A little challenge wouldn't hurt. End of the year, I was ranked top. Okay, what's going on? The next year, second year of high school, SPE was introduced. This was a new system whereby if you get to achieve certain grades, you get to skip 1 year of school to go to all levels. I failed. I didn't get it. What's going on, Farhan? After all those years of being number one from the bottom. That's it. I had to redeem myself. Need to climb back up. But it was hard really, climbing up from being at the bottom. So this was how it felt like, being as dumb as my primary school friends. As you can tell, I was still egoistic. So in the next year, the next big exam, I did the unimaginable. I was caught cheating. I dropped to the lowest point in my life that I had to cheat my way through. It was Miss Ivy. She was the one to blame. I knew it. I knew something was fishy. I was writing my paper, and I could feel she was strolling around the room. I was naive, but at the last moment, while I was writing, she yanked my phone from under my table. And on the phone, and on the screen, was an image of the current paper. She rushed off from the room. I was nervous. I was panicking. She came back half an hour later, knocked on my desk and pushed me to come with me. She didn't say a word. I stood up, followed her, could feel the stares of my classmates, curiously wondering what's going on. It was a daunting and scary walk. She led me to the principal. To my surprise, frozen, shocked in time, parents were. So as I sat down, parents side by side, Miss Ivy sitting there as a witness, recalling the whole event, principal, lecture. On the ride home, I stared outside the window in my car. My mother rambled on and on, tears. But I didn't listen. Father kept calm. And the next morning, Sally called me to her office. I thought I was in trouble, and I didn't really feel angry at that point. I don't know why. you feel accounting is a bit too hard for you, you can arrange some private tutoring. I believe you're much better than Shira Fomen. There was another odd occurrence. At the end of the year, miracle maybe, all the students were announced that no matter if you fail or pass the SPE exam, you are exempted. Maktab Science then made all the students skip 1 year of school. Perhaps this was that wake up. Let's take it. My mother pushed me for tuitions that following year. 5 nights a week to sacrifice with more school. But I enjoyed it. Frankly, I enjoyed it. I learned to enjoy learning. I became more respectful of my friends, my teachers. And I worked so hard that year that from a straight U student, I got 8 straight B's. Okay, come on, that's a big improvement. The next year, I decided to try something new, something fresh for a start. There was a new club going on in school called The Gavel. It had something to do with public speaking. So I joined and I fell in love with talking. I made more new friends, I made friends with teachers even. Soon after, I also discovered I love to volunteer. I volunteered so much that my body couldn't take it anymore. Even after graduating, I was still a volunteering enthusiast. Still came back to school, helped out the gavel. At the end of the year, there was an annual appreciation ceremony. And to my surprise, my gavel teacher invited me to attend for my help in the gavel. Ironically, I received my first award as a graduate. Honestly, never a student. So the day came, I sat alone in the front row, and a familiar voice called me. Hi, Farhan. Oh, it was Miss Aida. She gave me a piece of paper, she rushed off. I thought it was some sort of an attendance sheet. Then I looked at it, it was a handwritten letter. In the letter, she said, "Dear Farhan, I am proud. I saw you the other day in the newspaper because you were involved in the UBD Toastmasters. And I'm sure your parents are proud of you. Kudos on you for never letting the incident of cheating brought you down. Most people would. When we were called to sing the national anthem, I was crying." I had her for highly that following day. It took a while to get her. She was in the top floor of the reading room. I knocked and I ushered her to come up. Familiar feeling. Before I could say anything, I was already crying. Again. After a full minute, I told her, "Thank you for everything." Then she said, "For what? I didn't do anything." And I said, "Thank you for believing, especially to the one who taught me cheating. It's rare to find a teacher who believes in me and have faith." And she said, "You've gone a long way since I've taught you back in year 9. Now, I believe you can do far greater things in the future. Good luck to you." I asked for a hug. Ladies and gentlemen, we are all a part of who we have met. And the people around you are who they are because they have met. It was because of one person's faith and belief that I was able to climb out of that deep and dark hole. Imagine if there were more. Imagine if there was more. Simple actions by one person can change someone's life entirely. Never let one mistake, or tragedy be the reason for you to never willing to try. Instead, let that be motivation for you to grow even greater. By surrounding yourself with positivity, you too can achieve the unimaginable.